Very good morning to all of you. In fact, the Bhishma of conditioned monitoring and vibration, in fact, the person who taught, those persons who taught me, Dr. B.V. Rao sir, and Dr. Prasad, and my dear friends here. Somehow I have been trained in such a way that, you know, I need to focus specifically on the topics of interest, what we are discussing. In fact, I have planned a presentation for about 12 minutes on that. But what triggered my thinking was that question of spiritual legs. I'll just take a minute to explain my views on that. Globalization in economy, or mutually holding hands with each other, is applicable only for select few countries. Suddenly the chairman of Fed will announce that quantitative easing is likely to be discontinued. All the developing countries' economies will go for a 6, and at the fourth day he will say, I may have to reconsider by the time the country of interest has made the required money. That is mutual hand-holding. The countries which are likely to be a sort of technological challenges to the big nations are the nations which are always focused upon of their interest, so that they are forced to depend on them for every critical thing. Singapore is a separate. Singapore is not a challenge to any of those countries which are today talking about globalization in economy. We are. Once you are there in the arena of challenge, the total rules of the games are different. Okay. So this word globalization or mutual interest, holding each other hands, are all selective terms of this decade or century for making those countries which are already grown and developed to further grow and keep us at a different location. Okay. Having said that, it's open for debate. I'm willing to defend whatever I have said. Let me come to today's presentation. I have a very strong views on that, that's why. Okay. Gentlemen, Government of India, through its departments on science, like Department of Science and Technology, Department of Atomic Energy, Space, Agricultural Research, quite a few of them, have created sufficient support structures for funding of research programs. In addition to that, like Dr. B.V. Rao said, the culture of promoting research programs, both in private and as sponsored by individual philanthropists, is yet to pick up in this country. So most of the research is funded by the government. Department of Defense Research and the Ministry of Defense has a very well-defined norms and execution methodology for funding research projects, research works. In fact, DRDO has got a separate directorate called Directorate of Extramural Research, located in New Delhi, to whom any applications of research work can be addressed, irrespective of area, whether it is of direct relevance to DRDO or not. This directorate is supposed to forward those applications to the people who may be interested in that work in anywhere in Government of India, and depending upon the interest or the commitment or the likelihood of exploitation of that work, within a period of 3 months and sort of a presentation will be arranged, and the funding, whatever is required, will be debated and will be granted. There is no upper limit. This is the, what should I say, the what is there in the wall. But let me present to you the brass tacks. Many of us keep talking that, you know, there is no adequate funding, there is no support for research and all that. Since that, I am partly involved in some of these sponsorship grants. I know for sure, I can talk with numbers, that the number of people coming forward to take up research works from the academia with a commitment to meet the end results are really lacking vis-a-vis the funds that are being offered. DRDO in itself has got